So it's estimated that there are around 2 million Australians currently living with prediabetes. So prediabetes means that you've got a raised blood glucose level, not high enough to mean that you're diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, but higher than would be normally expected. So the good news is that prediabetes for the majority of people is reversible. However, type 2 diabetes is not reversible. Therefore, we have a small window of opportunity to make a big difference. So the key things in terms of reversing prediabetes is, first of all, weight control. So losing weight, that means that the insulin in your body can work more effectively. And so it's finding ways to lose weight. So exercise obviously is a good way of losing weight, and it also helps to regulate the insulin within your body. Eating a healthy diet with fruit and vegetables, so following the national guidelines, and sometimes medications, but this would need to be discussed with your GP.
I had struggled with my weight for years, and I was quite unhealthy at the time. I was unwell, just feeling very tired, foggy, all sorts of things. I went to the GP and I was diagnosed as being pre-diabetic. I wasn't aware of pre-diabetes. I'd never heard of it as a concept. I'd obviously heard of diabetes, but never anything about pre-diabetes. So over a 2-year period, I lost 64 kilos and have maintained it now for another 2 years. So I went back to my GP about a year and a half ago, and my blood sugars are perfectly normal, and I have no higher chance of having diabetes than anybody else. You know, I had a long history with food and a long battle with food, and if I can change my circumstances, then I think anybody can.
So we all know how difficult it can be to change our behaviour and to maintain that change as well. So support is key, be that through family, friends, or maybe through a health professional such as a nurse. So in our study, we found that people that worked with practice nurses to set goals at 6 months down the line lost on average 1.3 kg more than the group that did not. So at Edith Cowan University, we are collaborating with and leading on research in type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes.